Choosing a career was as much of a challenge then as it is now. General education was basic and most offspring followed their father's footsteps. Others were apprenticed to tradesmen so that they could learn a trade or craft and make a living. For those without recourses, education was basic at best, and parents looked at financial security for their children. Michael Faraday's father was a blacksmith's apprentice. In his childhood, Michael too worked as an apprentice to a village blacksmith. The family was not well off, and having received only a basic schooling, young Michael had to educate himself. At 14, he became apprentice to a local bookbinder and bookseller. Henry's father was a day laborer. Van der Waals worked as a carpenter, and Fourier was a tailor's son. Stephen's father was a miller at flour mill, and his mother was employed as a maid servant. Benjamin Franklin was removed from school at age 10 to work with his father at candle making. Hygiene was educated at home till the age of 16. He became a fugitive upon abandoning his apprenticeship. Galileo was luckier. His father was a wool merchant and he had better educational opportunities. He was enrolled as a medical student at the University of Pisa. While there, Galileo developed a fascination for mathematics and ignored his medical courses to such an extent that he left Pisa without a degree. Galileo went back to Florence to try to scrape a living as a private tutor in mathematics and natural philosophy, as physics was known in those times. 4 years after he left the University of Pisa without a degree, Galileo returned as a professor of mathematics. Even for those born with silver spoon in their mouth, physics was not an obvious choice of study or career. Many famous physicists started their career in medicine. Felix Severt trained for a career in medicine, however he spent more time studying physics than in treating patients. Despite Helmholtz's father's desire for his son to study medicine, as it was supported by the government, Helmholtz studied philosophy. Young obtained his doctorate in medicine from University of Göttingen. Gilbert was a doctor by profession, as well as being Queen Elizabeth I's physician. Foucault abandoned the study of medicine in favor of physics due to blood phobia. Fizeau came from a family of doctors and was also enrolled in medical college, but he had to withdraw on account of bad health. He later made his career in physics. Physics is such an intriguing subject that more than a few talented minds left their careers in wide range of other fields to study it. Biot started his career in commerce. He went on to serve in the army and was imprisoned for deserting. Later, he became a professor of mathematics and finally a professor of physics at the College of France. Avogadro's father was a well-known lawyer and he himself earned a doctorate of law. Newton's mother wanted him to be a farmer. He was once even withdrawn from school until his master persuaded his mother to send him back. Brewster was intended for clergy and was sent to the University of Edinburgh at the age of 12. De Broglie was a student of history. Physicists were often eclectic and versatile in talent. The most interesting case is that of Pauli. After a breakdown resulting from his divorce, Pauli consulted a psychiatrist and psychologist, Carl Jung. Jung's interpretation of his archetypal dreams so impressed Pauli that he went to become one of his best students.